Hi friends, and welcome to the Plain Fun RC channel. I'm your host, Saul, and we're about ready to start a whole new project. We are going to be getting into the St. Croix models, 1/5 scale, Burt Rutan Long Easy. And this kit dates back to 1983. I happened to find it mint, new in the box, at a train shop. The gentleman who owned the train shop was getting out of the airplane portion of the hobby, just wanted to focus 100% on trains. And he had this in his basement in his mint, new in the box. And we'll do an unboxing video in just a second. Let me go ahead and just kind of show you the label here. You can see some of the information and the required items for it as well. Now, St. Croix models, for those that have been watching some of the videos, they were the ones that also designed the quickie I built up here. You can see it, Burt Rutan quickie. And of course, we built two of those back to back because we had a second kit as well. And the other Rutan quickies right up here. As you can see. All right. So anyway, we're gonna get into the build for the Long Easy. We'll do a quick unboxing and then we'll get started. More to come. All right, friends, as we continue with our unboxing of the St. Croix models Burt Rutan Long Easy, you can see here it's a very complete kit, very well made. They even include the shaped nose cone. Now, initially, when I built the one back in 1983 when I was 13, the nose cone wasn't shaped. It was just a block of wood and you had to carve it out. So obviously this is a later kit where they actually carved it for you. But you've got a full set of instructions here that are included. You've also got a split cowling. As you can see here, this is the top portion right here, and this is the bottom portion right here. Underneath this package is our clear canopy. Down here are our winglets. And underneath the cowling here and the canopy, you'll see we have our foam cores, our wing foam cores. Everything is just packed very nicely. We've got a wonderful wood kit here. And it was a very complicated kit to build, but it was always very well packed. We even have our landing gear here as well. So if you're fortunate enough to find one on eBay or something, grab it and build it. It's a good experience, and I think you'll enjoy it. I never flew the one I had because it had a notorious history of being tail heavy at the time, but of course that was with the nitro engines. Now we've got electric where we can easily put batteries up front to offset the balance issue that the originals had. Anyway, that is the brief unboxing, and we'll have more to come as we move along with our build.